Tjan Bijl has been an absolute constant in the Dutch electronic music scene. Since the beginning of the 90s, he's released countless techno and house tracks. NY Stomp, G-Man, Litteron, Metro Dade or Davatar, the list of pseudonyms is almost as long as the number of influences that can be heard in his music. In fact, diversity is one of his greatest strengths. Under the name GERD and with a modern vocal-oriented form of house music, he's created his most popular alter ego to date. But what all his productions have in common, irrelevant of the alias, is their ability to sound contemporary.
When it comes to house and techno, I think, yeah, the prototype records already been produced in the 90s, and indeed, we tend to write the same track over and over again nowadays. But that's house music, I guess. Of course, you had some developments in the past. You know, you had subgenres that added something new. Most of them disappeared again, you know, and nowadays it came back to, yeah, house and techno, like we produced in the 90s. So nothing new when it comes to the music itself. But I think, how certain producers, you know, play within the genre, within, you know, when they just the way they write the track or the way they mix it, I think it still can be very interesting. I used to use a lot of sounds in music not when I started out, but maybe later in 93, 94. I made music and I tended to use a lot of sounds and a lot of details, a lot of things were going on in my tracks. And sometimes I had people coming up to me and say, yeah, good, but sometimes less is more. And at that time, it made me think. I was like, yeah, it's true, because you can have tracks sound better, much more punchy, you know. But on the other hand, if there's a lot of stuff going on, it can be an interesting trip for the listener, you know, because with every listen, you hear something totally different. The most fun part of making music is making the basic sketch. That's fun, you know, because usually it goes quickly. But when you want to make a basic sketch interesting, when you want to make it into a song, that's where the real challenge comes in. And arranging is very important to me because, of course, sometimes it's nice to have a loop. You can extend the loop, you can add a hi-hat, some effects, keep it very basic. And you can have a smashing track, of course. But for me, I tend to search for more excitement, more of a challenge in a track. Sound is very difficult to me. I try to achieve a certain punchiness in all tracks that I do. I'm very picky when it comes to sound. So, and I'm never satisfied with how my own tracks sound. You know, there are always little details you would like to change, but I find mixing very difficult. So it takes a lot of time for me to mix. I don't like when bass drums drown in a bass line or in sub. that's also what you hear a lot, you know, a lot of sub in especially techno tracks, and then you don't have the punch in the cup anymore. And I also tend to mix with a lot of sub, and yeah, it's difficult. So I try to achieve some sort of punchiness, and other than that, yeah, it can sound very rough. I mean, I have a lot of equipment here to make it dirty, but sometimes I like to keep it clean and sound. Music is a long trip. Yeah, it's a long, big exploration travel. I started making house because I got interested because of the house records coming out of America, you know, mid 80s, late 80s. Yeah, big adventure. And yeah, after some time, you know, I did house music in the 90s for a long time, of course. And after some time, bored is a big word. But yeah, you want to discover new things. And that's when I discovered how to make, well, more jazz-orientated music, or hip-hop even, and soul music. So yeah, diversity is very important to me. Focus is house music. I can't make house music all the time. I also have an alias called Literon, and under the Literon alias, I produce a lot of techno. And that's also, yeah, another aspect of modern dance music that is quite appealing to me, because techno has totally different energy compared to house. And I think it's very important to keep the creativity flowing. I never expected house and techno to be around for such a long time, I guess. I remember when we started out, a lot of people who weren't into house, they booed at us when we brought all our equipment on stage, you know, and they were like, the stupid house music of yours, you know, it won't go on for 2 years, or if you're lucky, 3 years, but then it's over again, you know. They literally were laughing at us. And I was like, well, no, I think it will go on for another 10 years. But look at us now, you know, we're 22, 25, maybe even longer, even more years further. And still no new thing came around the corner. We're still doing house music, and that's incredible. Thank you.